This is what I represent today in front of this August gathering, the Maritime Trainers Guild, where we believe there is but one wealth which grows by sharing, and that is knowledge. So whatever little knowledge I have on this topic, I would like to share with you today. The topic given to me today is collaboration of latest technology and education trends. It's a generic topic, however, I have tried to focus it more towards maritime training. However, interrupt me if you wish to discuss anything in a generic way or take questions after the presentation. We begin with stating the evolution of training. You all are aware of the chalk and talk method. Then came in e-learning by way of training presentations and computer-based training. Followed by webinars where a host sitting somewhere remote discusses with so many people who are there. Like presently, I think, sir, you are doing extra master classes also through webinar system. Then various names which we know, Seagull, Videotel, and off late our own Indian Cargo, where animated videos are produced and we learn about various hazards on board and also LFIs, learning from incidents. We have interacting animations, which is currently being used. For example, I have given over here the troubleshooting on air servo mechanism of Aalborg boiler. Gaming apps are coming in a big way. This is the time when we have moved from laptops to palm tops, and most of the learning. And during this discourse, I will also give you tell you a story wherein I was pleasantly surprised and I started rethinking whether I have updated myself as a trainer or not. Then the simulators, aptly represented here by ARI simulation. Virtual reality method, it is often used for training in surgery and for military training. We have also started using it in maritime education and training. I'll show you a small video to highlight what I have just said. Well, this is the power of digitalization, and it's not just talking, but actually I showed you that this is how the people can learn, our students can learn. However, moving forward, let us see some advantages and disadvantages. VR is not VR Marina, it is virtual reality. So basically virtual reality, accurate and realistic simulation with lifelike visual graphics, which you just saw. Some modules can also be done using a mobile phone. All this can be in the form of an app. This can be used from your ship or in home, wherever you can do this learning. It is not only 3D, but can also be into a 360 degree configuration. It brings in a huge reduction in infrastructure and cost effectiveness, ranging from simple to complex topics, anything can be dealt. Immersive and interactive, using hard as well as soft tools for voice commands. Now, although we are nearing lunch, and some of you must be feeling famished, but it drew your attention. So increased level of attention, higher level of retention, I'm sure you will never forget this video. Better understanding and more practice. Thus, the level of competency increases. This is a very common example which we see in our day-to-day life. For example, this interactive board being used in schools now, and having systems, LMS and other systems. I have given example of Baiju because it is very popular, people know about it. It is already in the school. And as some of the speakers before me mentioned that, even Mr. Krishnan and Dr. Shetty mentioned that, we have to think future. It is not just what has to be done today or tomorrow or 2 years or 3 years from hence. We have to think 10 years from hence. And this is the product which we will get in our shipping. The people who are learning from Baijus, people who are learning from their phones or palm tops. These are the people who will get. Now begins the story which I am going to share with you. I was in one of the classes and teaching some second mate candidates. And I was doing that normal conventional teaching, drawing on the whiteboard, showing some presentations. And it was a class of navigation. And I was teaching them about navigating a ship safely and efficiently, say from giving an example, doing it from Europe to America. And the thing was that I was explaining what is rum line and great circle sailing. So while I was teaching, I was noticing one boy sitting in the corner. He was continuously on his phone. So like any other teacher, I thought, she's also on the phone. I thought, what is he doing? Why is he on the phone? So while, as I was talking, I went over there and I saw he was reading something pertaining to what I was teaching. And I said, hello, what is this? I don't know. What is this? He said, this is the Polaris app. And what does this Polaris app tell you? Sir, all that what you're drawing by your hand, pencil, I've got it in graphics over here. So I'm understanding it better. That was an eye-opener for me. And that was the day when I said, no, I have to start going into artificial intelligence, digital learning, start learning. Then only I am trainer for the future. Otherwise, as it was mentioned by one of the speakers, that people who are retired, people who do not know, still they are teaching sextant or still they are teaching Deca Navigator. Yes, sir. One of the classes I saw a person teaching Deca Navigator. It is long obsolete. But he knew only Deca Navigator, so he was teaching Deca Navigator. So this is the futuristic what we should do. And moving further, I have summed it up as advantages of e-learning, whatever I have said, better simulation and models, global learning, more efficient assessment, e-books, epistemic game, student database and result tracking, interactive textbook and case studies, digitalization of everything, extended classroom communities, flexibility and online e-learning, making learning fun again means by gaming apps, cost reduction, video games, teaching by way of video games, and continuing in a very evolving fashion as a lifelong learning. Cost benefits, of course, 50 to 70% reduction in training cost. I'll skip this. I was trying to introduce something called neocortex. Do we have time? Should I?
Yes. Or,
okay.
10 minutes.
Oh, 10 minutes is good enough. Because the way we were learning before and the way which we are learning now, there's a gap. Especially when we say that you are teaching in a digital format, but assessment, you are asking him to do a 3-hour essay type question answer still. You have not yet transformed from that essay type question answer, 3-hour question answer. Although it is being done, but it is not yet successful, the digital part. An exit exam is one of the ways which my friend Ajay said that he is not in favor of exit exams.
No, I didn't say that.
Then, so the present way, present thing is still to test. That's what you said.
Can you repeat that?
The present scenario is still to test.
Whether it is reliable and valid.
Yeah, so it is still to test. The time will tell whether it is reliable or valid.
Whether we have specific learning objectives.
Hmm.
So right now, it's very subjective.
Okay, so there is still a gap. Okay, so explaining this, the human brain, of late, this is the normal, which we say reptilian brain and mammalian brain and neocortex, new brain, which has formed. And this has happened, the evolution has happened only in mammals. The perception, the new cortex, the perception of human brain and conditioning starts. These programs run the brain whenever it is in a, whenever it is possible on an autopilot mode. For example, you know, when you get up in the morning and you go to the toilet, you automatically pick up your brush without thinking and put a paste and start brushing your teeth. Or you go to the loo. So it is automatically programmed in your brain. More than 95% of the time, we don't think. The brain takes us what we want to do as a routine. Over the years, all information is being digitalized. For the diagram shows that how from the book reading we have started coming to digital modes of learning, and the new generation which is exposed only to the digitized information right from a very young age. Thus, slowly our brain got programmed to process digital information better. Now, this diagram tells us that now if to a new student, if you do a chalk and talk study, this is what happens. I hear, I forget, but when I see, I will remember. And all those with the people over here with young children will agree with me that now most of the students, even in school, are learning from palm tops or laptops. And when I do understand, I experience, then I'm ready. That is through a virtual reality. Thus, because of this new cortex brain, digital learning, but analog assessment is still possible. We learn digitally, and we give an assessment in analog form. Well, this is some statistics which I have collected. The worldwide e-learning market is projected to be worth $325 billion in 2025. Billion. In 2017, approximately 77% of US corporations used online learning. 67% of US companies offered learning opportunities via smartphones. E-learning increases retention rates by 25 to 60%. e-learning for companies grew by a stunning 900% between 2001 to 2017. E-learning has led to an increase in income of 42% of US organizations. A survey of 2,500 companies found that those with comprehensive training programs have 218% higher revenue per employee and 24% higher profit margins. IBM saved approximately $200 million after switching to e-learning. These are some populations, some statistics about India. This is based on last year's statistics, January 2020, we still did not get any statistics. Maybe later we'll have an update on this. But it gives us a good comparison picture vis-a-vis the world, what India is doing. Smartphones, the total population 1.361 and smartphones 1.1. Nearly everybody has got a smartphone. Internet users, 560 million in India. Active social media users, 310 million. And mobile social media users, 290 million. The percentages is also given below. Annual digital growth between 2018 and 19. Population increased by 1.1%, but mobile subscription increased by 2.8%. Internet users increased by 21% in 1 year. Active social media users increased by 24% in 1 year. And mobile social media users by 26% in a single year. Coming to the marine, do you think is digital learning good enough for training on board ships? I leave the question open to the audience. In my opinion, digitalization is no doubt a wonderful mode of delivery, but it's not entirety of training as far as Merchant Navy is concerned. This is my personal opinion. Till the time we have autonomous ships. Once we have autonomous ships, then this doesn't have any meaning. Then it is only digitized training which is required. Thank you so much.